What is up, baddies? We're back at it again. This is update number 2 for the fabrication. I know I didn't really show much last video, but here it is. Today I'm heading over to Gilroy, California to meet up with KPS. I actually ended up selling my seats. If you follow me on Instagram, you guys know my Corbo GTS2s, they're officially sold. Kyle, a friend of mine that was in my old mini truck group, actually let me borrow his stock 4Runner seat that bolts in directly to our 89 and 95 Toyota pickup. So I'm gonna go take the GTS2s, load them in the back of the pickup truck, bolt this one back into the truck, and I also got the coils finally. They're double adjustable QA1s with a 10-inch spring, 300-pound spring for the back. So it's double adjustable, meaning I could adjust the compression and the rebound. So that's pretty dope. And then I also got these subframe mounts. I'll put a picture here. Last time I was over at KPS, they said they needed them. So these were kind of tough to find. There was only like 3 on eBay, not in the best condition, but these basically go underneath the subframe, and I'll show you guys that once I'm over there. But super stoked, I got a lot of goodies for them. They could finally start on the cantilever coilover system. Before I head out, you guys see this gnarly dent? I don't know if you guys could see that. Oh, that's a good angle. It's horizontal one right here. I got smacked, and I don't know where it happened, but on the daily, I love keeping this thing clean. I already scheduled a paintless dent removal, and the guy has like amazing reviews, and I'll put like 3 before and after pictures right here. You guys can see how like it's right on the body line and he pops it out nicely. So I'm looking forward to that. Actually not looking for, I don't even know how to feel about this. I haven't even driven it since I got the dent because I'm so bummed out about it. But we'll be back on the road soon with the daily. We have arrived to KPS Motorsports. I'm always like so nervous pulling up right now because I'm always like, what is this gonna look like? They always knock it out of the park. So super stoked. All right, follow me up. I see a little booty. Okay, before I even get, oh, suspension's not even in. Oh, okay, I see what they did. All right, so they took off the independent rear suspension. They put my solid axle just to leave it out here basically. This is this like Time Attack Subaru that they're working on. Super wide, huge diffuser. And they just finished up this roll cage, and this thing looks sweet. Oh, they painted it white too. The welds are so quality, dude. You could just tell. Look at that. I'm gonna start ripping out the seats. Sun's in the way, you can't really see it, but the seat was back there. I slid it forward. It's a 14 millimeter socket. In here, I'm gonna take off these back to the 2 front, and this thing's coming out. She's up. And she's out. Passenger side is out. All right, so just a quick little update on the rear of the truck. Concerning the frame, a lot of people were saying that the independent rear suspension upper control arm was way too close. It was about 2.5 inches. I wish I could give you guys kind of like a more visual thing, but that's where I hand it off to Josh.
How's it going, everybody? Josh at KPS Motorsports here, working on the Bad Lux, Giovanni's Hilux back there. We're doing rear suspension this time around, and I'll show you guys what we got going on so far. We went ahead and removed all the stock suspension, took the bed off, that way we have access to do all of our work. And we've been mounting the 240SX subframe and control arms and everything that he provided to us. He brought all this stuff over. The only thing we don't have for it is shocks, because we're actually doing a cantilever bed mounted shock system once we're done mounting the subframe and all that. So the upper part of this is a weld in brace that holds these rear mounts. It's all DOM roll cage style tubing, keeps it nice and clean, nice and neat, very strong joints with a pretty simple installation. Over here, I designed these pocket mounts. These are sheet metal fabbed onto a 1/4 inch base plate, and that's what holds the front mount. We're gonna have to remove this section of frame rail, build some sheet metal back where it used to be, so that way we have room to run the push rod for the shock. So still lots of work to do, but it's coming along pretty nicely, and we'll keep posting video updates as we go along.
Baddies, these are the QA1 double adjustable coilovers with a 10-inch spring, 300-pound spring, right? And now what we're looking at is we're going to be doing a cantilever coilover suspension, like Josh said. So basically, I'm not sure if I want them, the tops of them, pointed out towards the back of the car. A setup like that would kind of look like this. That's kind of what we would be looking at, like right there, or mounting them from this bar right here. Another thing I want to mention is there's going to be a cutout when the bed is here, and the fuel cell is going to be halfway submerged, meaning that halfway is going to be under the bed, half of it is going to be up top. That way I can like still open the top cap and, you know, fill it up with fuel. It's going to be a 16-gallon custom-made fuel cell for this application. And KPS Motorsports makes all of that. So these are one of the reservoirs that they made, the welds on it, welding aluminum. Like that is tough, and these guys out here doing it, man. Ah, what is that? I need that. Gonna throw the tool bag in there, and I'm gonna load these up. I gotta take this off so we have space to throw these in. We got it nice and prepped up, so now we gotta load these in, but I have to find my rear suspension and the sway bar because I'm selling that, and also my Black Widow muffler over there. You guys could see it. Has the gold tips on the floor. All right, so I got the rear sway bar. Gonna walk it over here. Thank God they separated it from the rear diff, because this with the rear diff and the leaf springs would be too much. Okay, now these go in. Oh! The seats are in. Now we just gotta tie them up, make sure they're not gonna fly all over the place on the highway. Imagine, sheesh. Oh, I gotta return the deposit. I'm gonna light. And they're ready. Wait a minute. This looks kind of weird. I don't know. It seemed like a good idea. I don't know. This just looks kind of weird. Like, oh, and I can't even see people behind me. We can do this. Okay, so I didn't know they actually recline all the way. So that's much better. I'm tripping, dude. So that's this week's update. Shout out to Josh. Shout out to Zach. Hooking it up here at KPS Motorsports, and you already know what I'm gonna say. I'll see you next time, baddies. What is up, baddies? Here I have Bad Kira. I keep this thing extremely clean just because, I mean, it's the daily. I want it to look nice. I don't know. I'm just like that. You guys already know me. So let me do some. Actually, I haven't even shown you guys all the stuff I've done to it, but I'll include that in another cinematic. It's super clean though. You guys should follow me at Bad Hira. But yeah, I parked this car at my girlfriend's house for like two nights, just two nights, dude. I never really do it. I parked it on the street and I woke up to this. It's a dent. Now, I do know my options. It's either body work, obviously, which I don't want to do because when they repaint the panel, they're going to bondo this, blah, blah, blah. It's not going to look the same, right? So I looked up paintless dent repair because I've seen it a lot on my Instagram. And I hit up the guy that does like the best paintless dent removal in the Bay Area. And he's going to come over right now. I'm going to transfer the video over to him. But hopefully, I mean, we could do anything with this. I did hopefully make it a little easier for him by taking out the back seats, and I think either that might be an access hole or this one. I'm not sure. Just trying to make it easy for him. I don't know.
There's also a screw down here that he can have access to maybe poke this out. I don't know. He has his whole setup. I'll show you guys his setup. And he's going to put a heat gun to it. I don't know what he does. I'm going to let the experts do it. People are like, just put a glue stick on it. I can't do that. So let's see how this turns out. So here's before. This is probably going to be like a 1 to 2 hour process for him. But otherwise, besides that, the car's so clean everywhere. Like, look at this. Super clean.
Here we go. Here we go on another ride along. Woo! So today's job, we got an Acura that came in, and this dent is on the rear quarter panel. We call it a dog leg. You get the wheel and then that little piece of metal that goes down by the wheel towards the middle of the car. It's called a dog leg. And the dent happened there. The customer doesn't know how it happened. It's just one of those things that happened in the parking lot. And today we're gonna do glue pulling on that. It's a good size dent. I think it's like this big, but I have to do glue pulling on it because I cannot get a tool behind it at all. So here we are, we're at the customer's house. I've already introduced myself, but I wanna show you guys the car and the job I'm about to tackle. Let's head on in. Here we go, Acura TL. That is one bad Acura. Thing is so clean. Original paint. Woohoo. So clean. And here is the dent. See that? Dent right there. That's our glue pulling dent that we're going to do today. Here we go. There's the dent. There's my light. My hot glue. Some of my glue tabs. And hammers. So I'm all finished here with the glue pulling on this dent. This thing came out cherry. It came out so good. Customer was super, super happy. Amazed that it just gone. Can't even see any speck of it left. I'm super, super happy with it. Customer's happy with it. This was a fun job. Took me a while. It was a fun job, especially doing it for such an awesome customer like that. Anyway, take care. See you on the next dent.
I am completely blown away. Jim just left right now. You guys just seen that video. Let me show you what the dent looks like now. What dent? It used to be right here. And you cannot see anything. I can't see it. He literally, the body line is right here. The body line is completely straight all the way down. Look at that. What in the world? I cannot see anything. This guy's amazing, dude. JS Dent Plus. He works all over the Bay Area. Hit him up for a quote, send him pictures. It's free, it's quick. This guy's amazing. Honestly, I can't say enough good things about him.
Don't forget, hit the like button and subscribe. Thanks a lot, bye.